Yo, what's up, guys? Yo, I'm your host, yo, Mr. Yuck, dude, and welcome back to Alliance Battles Part 13. And you are tuning in to my YouTube channel, yo, Mr. Yuck Forever, all one word, baby. You know it. So, if you haven't subscribed to my channel by now, what the hell are you waiting for? Yo, it's real easy. Just go over there and hit that subscribe button. Yeah, if you like the video, by the way, yo, please leave a thumbs up. If you don't, thumbs down, you know, whatever. It's up to you. And leave a comment at the end. If you have any questions or if you like the video, my attacking strategy, yo, all the above. So, we rocking and rolling, man. Trying to put all these things out. 52-1 is the record stands right now. Got my redemption. Last episode on the one battle that I did lose, I played it really smart on that. So trying to get another streak going here. If you don't know, I have already put together all the videos. Just got to do some slight editing and audio commentary over the next 8 videos, including this one. So up to part 20 is as long as it's gonna last. If you think I was cheating or something, you can look at my dog tags. You know, every like 200 dog tags or so is my next alliance battle. So trying to keep it legit here, and I know season 2 is almost over, but I didn't really want to record any of like my attacking. I did record some of my attacking for season 2, but wanted to highlight more on my defensive strategies and stuff. I already talked about that, so one of the main things I want to re-highlight on is for these 20 videos that I've put out is really highlighting how well my entire setup works on a wide variety of bases. And using my specials wisely and all of that makes it to where you can pretty much beat almost any base. You know what I'm saying? Like, you've seen me attack a wide variety of bases. So if you like my strategy that I'm using, I mean, you can see what perks I'm running right at the beginning of each loadout. And I go really in depth on it on my commando and machine gunner advanced review. I currently think it's still the best attacking setup. Running with 3 surgeon veterans, and then 7 commando veterans, and then a machine gunner, riot, medic, a sergeant, commando, and then grunts, of course. So I've attacked this guy quite a few times. I mean, I just kept pairing me up with this guy. So feeling really confident, you know, I'm just gonna go right in. His one bombardier survived right there. Not a big deal. I'm gonna try to use his commandos and help get rid of these bombardiers right here. So they don't got iron lung. All my dudes are bunched up really nicely. Almost wasted a tear gas right there. And another reason why I only run like 3 surgeons versus more surgeons or less surgeons. 3 surgeons makes it to where, like, if a surgeon goes down, surgeon can pick that surgeon up. When there's 3 of them, they cover a pretty wide area in where all your units are. But I don't like to have more than 3 surgeons. If you run to a base that's all bombardiers or all rocketeers, surgeons cannot pick up dudes that are downed from explosive damage. So if your troop dies, you know, from a bombardier or rocketeer, you know, they just go flying. Surgeons can't pick those guys up. So I think it's really well balanced having three surgeons. Is my coffee done? I'm making some coffee over here too. So once again, man, I'm be giving out rankings for pretty much everybody that I'm attacking. I may have forgot one on the last video, like on the very last guy or something. Maybe I remember. But at this point, you know, I've attacked this guy like quite a few times. Easy, like as always. I don't even know how he would change his setup. Just the five snipers on that sandbag. He really needs to, like, spread those out or something, or move them forward. Move a group of them forward. Have like two sandbags or something. Something's got to change there. No iron lung. Even on his bombardiers, you get rid of, you know, most of them on that back sandbag that's facing towards Gap Rock. If you can only leave like one bombardier on there, you know, and then throw one more decoy up there or tear gas, like you're good to go. So give it like a 2. I don't know what I've rated him before, but like this is like a 2 base. So here we are again. I faced the is it Bearden or Breden? I can't remember his name. I think it's Bearden. Attacked him. I don't know how many times. Yes, I do. I think I mentioned it was about 20. So we're gonna mob through this base again. And I have no idea if I did on this attack. Most likely not. I do it sometimes if I have a no rally flag. I'll cut through the bottom section of all those walls with like a focus fire. And then come up through the side, so like most of his snipers ain't even getting a good angle on my dudes. But is that coffee done? Yeah, I think that coffee's done. Yeah, I'm gonna go grab a cup real quick. And I know I've said it in a couple of my other videos, man, but it really does mean a lot to everybody out there in the Guns Up community. To watch my videos, man, and know that my opinions are actually valued, like in the forums, you know, not just like, oh, this guy is just some tool who don't know what he's talking about. Like, I'm not trying to be like pompous or anything when I'm rating people's bases. I just want to give like accurate feedback on how strong I think a guy's base is, you know, with my setup. And the current setup I was running before this, I would have to say that I would think that a lot of these bases would have been more difficult. Bases that I gave maybe like a 5 rating to would be like 7s. Bases that I thought were like 7s, where it was a close call. I'm pretty sure I would have lost against those bases, but with this setup that I'm running, it just makes a lot of bases like super easy. So if you haven't tried running this setup, you should definitely give it a go. And I know running new setups are kind of scary. When I first started running the machine gunner and commando as my two primary damaging units, I wasn't really sure, you know. I was like, damn, dude, I just want to complete their metal. And the more I used it, the more I'm like, wow, like this is super good. And then tweaked their perks a little bit and started getting better and better with it. And then I got to the point where I'm like, man, I was running 10 commandos and it was good, but I was like, dang, you know, sometimes you're getting pooped on. So then I started running with the three surgeons, and I'm just like, yo, this is the god setup, yo. This is the meta right now. This is the meta. So you may be thinking, all right, yo, yeah, this might be the meta, dude, but what about for defense, man? You know, I've heard you talk before in your review. Maybe you watched the review and you were like, damn, dude, It does look like very, very OP at attacking, dude, but they suck on defense. I've actually now created a very amazing defensive base. You know, my base is very strong right now. Running commandos as my veterans. As the command of 7 commandos and 3 surgeons. It is absolutely devastating. And that was one thing that I had problems with right before Alliance battle started. Was I had 10 commandos. I wasn't even running surgeon. I had 10 commandos, right? But my defense was a joke, you know. I tried a bunch of different techniques and stuff, and it was just not good. You know, people were like pooping on me like left and right. And so that kind of leads into my next topic, where after episode 20 is done, I might even do it before that. But I want to definitely do it before Alliance Battle Season 3 comes out. It's like the top sniper tower locations, man. And I think anybody that watches that, no matter what level you are, it's really going to help you out. It's going to make everybody's bases a lot more difficult. And I would like to see even more difficult bases in Season 3. So, Bearden, I've beat you a bunch of times, lost no commandos there. I did get my surgeons pooped on. No, it's going to be like a 2 or a 3. I've just attacked you too many times and I know the exact layout of your base. And just keep in mind, you know, like if you do lose like quite a bit, just really think about like what happened when you lost. You know, are you not coming in with the right cards? Do you not have your medals completed? Are your perks not good enough? Do you not got like the right hero perks or not enough of them? And if you do lose, and you go, oh man, that sniper tower is so stupid. Like on this base, for example, I talked about this maybe last episode or 2 episodes ago. Where you have a sniper tower that's open, but has a tank trap right there. And potentially can shoot your truck if your truck's pushing up and you keep spawning grunts, you know, pierce through. And let's say you were in an alliance battle against this guy, and that did happen, and the sniper tower pooped on your truck. And you go, that is the dumbest thing ever, and you go and you complain on the forums. Well, currently, it's a part of the game. Units can't walk over tank traps, as you know. That's what they are, tank traps. They're used to stop movement, you know, in real wars. And maybe you should be like, okay, you know, that's actually a very good spot for a sniper tower. You know, maybe I should put that in my base. And those are some of the things I want to talk about in building an amazing base, building the ultimate base. Is not complaining about the things that suck, even though if they maybe changed, we definitely need to talk about them in the forums and on videos. That make sure the devs know that things do need to be changed. But if it's super cheesy, man. Then put that into your base, man, because it is part of the game. If you think walk arounds need to be changed and you're like, oh my gosh, dude, walk arounds are like the hardest thing ever. Maybe then put a walk around in your base. You know, save a clip where you challenge some guy's base and he had a walk around. You know, maybe you can just copy his walk around and then try it out in your base and see how you like it. And just be like, oh man. Hey, you know, I thought this was the worst thing ever in the game, and now I have it, and now it's pretty cool. You know, I can use that against the people I was getting shit on by. So right there, you know, I don't got a rally flag, and what I thought about maybe doing was I've talked about it before, where I don't have a rally flag, I just 2 of my focus fires. I could have queued up all of my main troops right there. and then focus fired through there, and then probably focus fired through the bottom. However, I didn't do that. And I did his sniper tower hit my truck once? It might have. And he has a free roaming snipers too. So you gotta kind of be careful of that. The segmented walls back here, I already really like it. You know, I have a somewhat of a similar design on my base. His anti-air isn't quite covering right there. So if I can get one more aerial, I can do a double overlay and then at least hit maybe those two sandbags on the southern side of his base. So now he's got three snipers walking forward. I really want to get a good grunt spam going right now. I don't want those snipers getting around that northern gap rock and pooping on my truck. So it's looking good. And there's the third aerial. Another thing you want to be really cautious of is, like, if you're running like low on troops and you're getting ready to like throw some aerials out or something, make sure you don't throw like two aerials down to like, you know, take the focus fire of like two anti-airs, and then you have like no troops and your screen gets pulled back, because that's happened to me before, like right there for example. And oh my gosh, that can be like absolutely devastating. So going a little unorthodox, he does have those free roaming snipers, so it's like, dang dude, I'm having to waste a little more munitions that I want. Make sure that back anti-air doesn't take my bombing run, because that'd just be a waste. And
what?
I waited just a second too long. And it's like, oh my gosh, I just burned four aerials right there. Four aerials. That would have taken out. Oh man. So it's pretty unfortunate. Just waited a split second too long. I didn't think that one, you know, front anti-air was gonna get his missile. And then I'm just stupid, and I just should have just popped both of them, considering I wouldn't have been able to use my missiles again anyways. So definitely want to try to break through both of these back walls too, and get this anti-air. Should slow down my troops just a little bit as well, and keep spawning those troops out of my truck. Try to get them bunched up as much as possible. So this is where it looks like it's going to be a little challenging. If I'm going to shoot these guys in this mid choke point, all these snipers might be shooting at me. So it's looking a little scary. I decided to wait, and there's another volley. All right, so not too bad. Ryder still might be hurt, so I need to drop this decoy. Let's get a good focus fire. All right, really good focus fire. Yo, and is dropping me decoys like mad. So bunker's almost out of the way. I get a rally flag, and I'm gonna rally forward so I'm not focused on that top anti-air. use that tear gas. And you see now, when the rally flag ran out, my troops turned around and then got that that anti-air right there. It's a really good technique. I talk about it in my HQ KO and rally flag as a focus fire. So at that point, you know, if you rally forward, your troops are going to ignore any buildings behind them, like it did right there. Really clutch plays right there. Unfortunate move on my four aerials that I wasted. It was a pretty good setup. I wasted four aerials. They could have been anything else, decoys or tear gases. The no iron lungs hurt him. Pretty sure he didn't have iron lung, right? And it did drop me those two decoys, but at the end I still had two decoys left over. A clutch play though on the rally flag dropping to me and then rallying forward. Yo, that was, oh my gosh, I needed that special so bad. So I give his base like a 5, even though I did some dumb stuff. It could have been harder. I don't know. Maybe like a 4. I just feel like I got lucky with the rally flag queuing up there at the end. Even though I didn't use the two decoys, like let's say it would have just dropped me like a firebomb right there, and it didn't give me those two decoys. There goes all my luck, and you know it could have been a lot different. So I'm gonna have to give that at least a 5. Can't downplay how that base went down. So. So this is kind of interesting. I see all these grunts coming up here. I'm like, what the hell? I'm kind of confused. I've never seen a base like this. So already on originality, you're gonna have to give you like a 10 on that, bro. On originality. And his grunts must have speed on them because they're just booking it. So I need to pop out a little bit more troops because I need my truck to start advancing up. At least a little bit. It's weird because he has like a bottom walk around and a top walk around as well. So it's like, I'm trying to see like kind of like where my troops are gonna go. I'm thinking they're probably gonna go to the bottom side, but I need to be a little cautious. I don't want any spray damage really to be getting back there, because if my truck starts moving down center choke point, those snipers are just gonna poop on my truck. So a lot of times when people are running the HQ command card, the sharpshooters and the grunts, every once in a while I'll throw out a riot shielder. So I want to try to get rid of these guys already. The spray damage is most likely going to hit them. Thank you. So I didn't really want to rally right in the middle because, you know, those snipers still might be springing back at me. So I figured, hey, I can try out a tear gas on them. It's not going to be a big loss if it doesn't work. At least it'll let me know later on in his base if his guys have iron lung. So they do got iron lung. So back part of his base doesn't look too daunting. I still got a rally flag, three focus fires, two decoys. So this is what I'm gonna try to do here. That technique again, I'm gonna try to rally forward. So I'm not worried about the bunkers. Well-placed focus fire. I'm focus firing on a set of sandbags. The wall and that sniper tower. So I'm gonna just tear gas to stop the sniper tower and the bunker from shooting back. I'd have to say the base actually has a pretty decent design. It could be a lot more of a truck killer if there was like a couple modifications to like his walk around. Somehow I'm not sure how he would do it, but I could see how this base could be a lot more difficult. For me, I think I just placed my specials really well. Rallied forward at the perfect time instead of rallying back again because I was already 45 out of 45 troops. There's no point in rallying back. Rally forward so I'm not focused on those bunkers and use my focus fires effectively. Even though I lost only one dude right there, the base was more difficult than the veterans I lost. So I mean I'd probably give that like a solid 5, man. Like a solid 5. I played everything like really smart. We have a couple tweaks, couple modifications in there. And that base could be absolutely devastating. I like the iron lungs on the snipers. For sure, but I don't know, the first engagement with snipers or whatever. You only got two anti-airs there. So being able to take out like one side, if you get your aerials right, like that hurts. Maybe if I didn't, you know, it would have been more difficult. I would have had to use most likely like another decoy right there. But then that's just saying, hey, you don't have two extra aerials you picked up, you know, one of them was a decoy. So personally, I'd probably drop another AA there, but so these the choke point into his first layer can be a little difficult around like where that northern tower or southern tower rock is. But I see a couple things to where I'm thinking, yo, I'm just gonna queue up right here. It gave me another rally flag. I'm gonna be able to pop out massive amounts of heavy troops. And I'm gonna get quite a few riot shielders in here. Look at this. So I don't want to rally back again because it's that first engagement's not very scary. So right there, I'm able to defeat that first engagement, not using any of my my specials. Now my troops are bunching up. So now it's like, all right, what do we want to do here? Just wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. Decoy at perfect time. So I chose to use my tear gas on the colonels, because like I don't want them like focus firing on a bunch of my dudes. So now we're just gonna rally everybody forward. Ooh. And he only has like one AA back there now, so. So he kind of has like an AA trap there, but I don't know, my units are, like, they didn't even go for it until it was like too late, so. And I have seen bases that properly use riot shields spawning out of tents, but this was just not one of them. Just too easy. Like everything about that base just screamed a 1 out of 10. Like first engagement, like even if you didn't have a rally flag, you know, you can play that part really easy and then let your troops bunch up and drop all of your veterans, and now I would have two focus fires and then come in and, like, double focus fire. But you know, you can just queue up all your dudes if you only had one rally flag. Get to that first engagement. You're not really gonna get shit on. You're just gonna have to eat some of those shots. Beat it. Rally back as you've been summoning more troops. Then let them all bunch up and then and beat that base. So you just can't let something like that. You just gotta be smarter in a base design. So the way he has his walls kind of placed, in his front entrance, you know, leads me to believe that I'm probably just going to be able to grunt spam this pretty good. And if I can get my grunts like hella bunched up, I should be able to just take out like these two sniper towers. So I'm going to try to use one riot shielder in here. And maybe that will like help stop the commandos as well, because I really don't want to use any of my specials right here. And I want to just keep trying to grunt spam this really hard. This bottom sniper tower might be able to like go through and like hit my truck as it pushes up around that top rock. So it worked out really good. One reason why it was an easy engagement, but why I didn't summon up my entire squad right there, is because my truck would still be in the very back until I killed those first two sniper towers. And then as my troops started moving up, my truck's gonna move up, but any troops that I'm spawning out of my truck at that point aren't gonna be able to reinforce like my front line. So it would just be absolutely stupid to just summon up all your troops right there. So kind of hoping that that a grunt spam could just get rid of that little section. But I was like, fuck it, let's go for it. So I'm gonna try to catch all of his troops as they're headed around this bottom rock, actually. And normally I would have probably rallied back right there and then caught his troops as they were headed around that northern side. But I decided to say fuck it. I'm still can't decide what I want to do with the rally flag. So finally calling my rally. And it was kind of a bad place rally. I wasn't sure what I wanted to do with it because my troops are still going to be spawning up. Probably should have used like my focus fire right there, but I kind of wanted to save it to the end. Even though this doesn't look like too daunting or anything. And I still got, you know, fucking four decoys. So now time to burn all my aerials. Like fuck it. Nothing too scary in the back part of his base, you know what I'm saying? Like, even though I had like a miscue on my rally flag, and my troops are still spawning out of my truck and going north, I should have at least probably like used the focus fire and broke through that wall right there so my troops could have like paired back up with my first wave and then rallied back. But you know, it's whatever. I'll have to give his base like a 2 or 3. But yo, on that note, once again, yo, thanks for all the support, guys. If you like the video, yo, thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't by now. You know, Mr. Yuck Forever, all one word, baby. All one word. And I'll see you back here next time for the next part of these Alliance battles, you know what I'm saying?